Welcome to our new show. In this series, we will be showing you how to build things and solutions on Google Cloud. It will be hands-on, with moderate exposure to code, and with links to reference guides and tutorials. And I promise you, no slides.
Promises. Number one, no slides.
No, not even slides that say no slides. In this first episode, I will show you how to get started with the Google Coral Development Board. All right, roll the intro. Google Coral is a platform for developing and prototyping machine learning models and running them locally on your hardware. You can develop the models using TensorFlow or very easily with services like Cloud AutoML. If you follow the links to Coral's website, you can study more about the hardware, the software, the different form factors of the boards, and you can buy your own development kits online. But what exactly is inside one of these Coral development boards? Let's take a look. Out of the box, the development board does not have an operating system image. So before you can start using it for the first time, you need to flash the board with a copy of the Mendel Linux operating system. To do that, you can follow this link to the Coral website, and the Getting Started guide will show you step by step how to do this. Or you can follow this link to another episode of this video series and see me execute those steps. But now it's time to start using the board. So let's connect to it. First, we connect the board to our machine using the USB-C OTG port, and then we connect the power cable. While the board is booting up, let's browse to the Coral website, click on Pre-compiled Models. We scroll down a bit, find MobileNet SSD version 2, and download the model file and the labels file. Let's check that we have the two files, and then using MDT push tool, we transfer them over to the development board over the USB-C cable. And then we can use MDT shell to log into the board. We check that we have the files there. I will make a subdirectory for them and transfer them over to that subdirectory. And then we execute a pre-built demo application called HDPU Detect Server. And we point it to the model file and the labels file that we downloaded. This will start a local web server on the board, exposing port 4664 on the local IP address. When we browse to that, we can see a live view from the AIY camera in this case, running through the HDPU and the model, and we can see the live object detection inference results on the screen. So we can see our apples, bananas, oranges, no scissors, being detected at about 16 milliseconds latency and 50 FPS. You can break the execution. Let's now connect the HDMI cable and run another version of this demo application called HDPU Detect. We can run it in full screen mode. And then on your monitor, you can see the same live object detection inference results from the board. So, looks like our development board is running nicely now. That's it for this first episode. If you liked it, press the like button, leave a comment below, and if you want to be notified of future...
We should do unboxing.
What?
Do unboxing.
But this is a prototype. I never had a box. It came in a bag. I have a bag.
Do unbagging.